What's up, fuckers? I've really wanted to make a video like this, just because I've been reading the Quarter Snacks articles as of late, and they recently just started redoing this. And I've always wanted to, I guess, review skate videos and kind of just give my opinion. So I'm going to give my takes on some of my favorite skate parts or videos per se. Here we go.
All right, so my first one, probably my favorite one, probably my most memorable, because this was one of the first video premieres in Richmond that I saw at the Bird Theater. Drumroll, Jake Johnson, Minefield. How the fuck can you not love this part? I mean, this is where I first heard of Animal Collective. I mean, the song My Girls was pretty fucking static back then. And just the way that the part matches with the song. And I mean Jake Johnson's skating is pretty one of one. He's got that, like, especially like him on Alien Workshop, when that was like the team to be on, when Ave and all those guys were on it. I think the trick that I always fucked with the most, and I always used to see like gifs of, was that the wall ride on the Jersey Barrier to front tail. That was just really sick. And just the wall ride at the end, or maybe I'm thinking of a static four part, but whatever the fuck his ender was, I know that shit was epic. And the gap, the back lip, like also the gap to 5-0. But yeah, that is one, if not like my favorite video part ever. Another one, this isn't really a video part, but it's more, I think it's a Ben Chadorn, I don't know how you pronounce his name, video. It's an Alex Olsen Nike SB Ben Chadorn video, Swoosh. I don't know where it's filmed. I think it's in Paris, somewhere in Europe, but it starts off with that backside flip on the red brick. The music is pretty sick. I don't know who it's by, but you know, I think one of the things I really like about all of these video parts that are favorite of mine are how the music and the just matches with the skating, just because you know this is really cliche, but music and skateboarding videos, I mean, that's like when you're a kid, and even now, like, that's how you find music, and that's kind of how sometimes you curate taste. But I mean, just like the cab flip at the end and him doing the nose bump on those ledges, I think that's in Paris, I think, I'm not too sure, was just really sick. And just like, Alex Olsen's also one of my favorite skaters. I mean, his Lakai part, his fully flared part was like next gen, and I think it was like whenever it came out, so like between 08 and 010, 011. But he's always been like a super, like, I've always wanted to skate like him. For some reason, I mean, he has like a wicked crazy style. Maybe he gets it from his dad, but that video was really, really sick. Like I said, these are in no order, and this one is a lot more recent. K-Rod FA part that just dropped. That's only like a minute and 50, not even 2 minutes long. That shit was sick. The wet grip tape, doing the nollie inward heel to wall ride, and then that nose slide to tail slide, that shit was crazy as fuck. And I think everybody has one of those favorite skaters that that doesn't drop anything, and then when they do, it's like world stops for like a couple weeks and just watches that part on repeat. I watch that part like 3 or 4 times a day at one point. That shit is sick. The music was great. The spot selection, like his ender, that little board slide on the little the ribbed neighborhood rail, sidewalk rail, garden, whatever the fuck, that shit was so awesome. This one might be a throwback for some folks. Chima Ferguson Real Since Day One remix with the Odd Future song. The one trick I think about constantly from that video is that dude has hops. I mean, I don't know what they're feeding those folks that are coming from way down under, but there's no way you can back three over a rail with that big of a drop. That shit was crazy. And there are a lot of clips in him in that video, I think, that are super sick of him skating in Authentics. I don't know if anybody has skated Authentics before, but they just have, like, it feels like you're wearing a pair of, like, Chuck Taylors, like a pair of Cons. And he just rips. And, like, a huge switch heel, or is it a switch flip? I can't remember. Huge switch heel over a rail from flat. And he's got a couple of really good combo lines in there. But he's one of those guys from the real team that has, like, a little bit of tech game, but also skates rails and jumps over and jumps down big stuff. And I don't know if he ever really got, like, the creds he deserved, but he was definitely really, really, really sick. Chima. Another really good one. It's a team video from FA. I don't remember what year it's from, but Industrial Lights and Magic. I think FA does a really, really good job of making team videos, especially when the other Kevin. I can't call him the other Kevin. Kevin Taylor? Fuck, I guess. Kevin Bradley. I think that's what his name. Yeah, Kevin Bradley. That, the trick that stuck out to me the most, obviously, was the ender. The back tail at the end was fucking nuts. Very crazy. I watched his, he had an interview with Gary Rogers that was, like, really interesting. They kind of bounce back and forth with each other because they go back way back when, apparently. That video was really sick. There's some other noticeable tricks in that. Sage had that front tail on the same ledge, I think, to heel flip out. It's a shame that he doesn't really skate like that anymore, but everybody kind of goes, like, ebbs and flows with, like, skating and going through other modes of expression and artistic stuff. What are some other cool tricks? I think Andrew Allen had some tricks in there, which is pretty cool. And sidebar, I never knew that Andrew Allen used to be a lot more tech. I think he's definitely from, like, the Velia Garda of West Coast skateboarding. And, it's crazy that he's still relevant. A lot of older skaters, I feel like this is just coming from, like, my biased opinion of what I've seen as I've, like, grown up to become, like a late 20s 9-to-5 skater, essentially. They just, like, burn out, and their sponsors just don't fuck with them. But obviously, you know, FA and Vans still really rocks with Andrew Allen, which is really, really cool to see. I think he deserves it a lot. Also, Jason Dill, I don't know how he's managed to formulate such a good team. He did a really fucking good job with this one. Yeah, so thanks for whoever tuned into this. I know, like, the tricks and some of the shit that I mentioned was probably wrong, and, like, the tricks and like the commentary don't mix up, like, line up correctly, but, you know, it's whatever. I'll probably make another one of these because I have, like, a lot of parts that I think are really, really good, and what better way to spew my own bullshit than on my own YouTube channel. So, more to come. Much thanks. Hasta la próxima. Ya tú sabes, weón. Bueno.